Hello learners, nice to meet you all again in a new topic today, and that is compound nouns. Okay, it's an interesting topic, and all engineers, technologists, whenever they do their first year BE, BTech degree, they will give this topic in their first semester almost in all the colleges. Okay, so I'll make it very easy and simple. Okay, for all the students on how to expand a compound noun. So you all know very well, compound means two or more nouns put together. We call it as a compound noun. Okay, the main purpose of expanding a compound noun is to describe a given object in greater detail. Because as an engineer, as a technologist, you should know how to communicate with clarity, that is more important. Okay, say for example, if they give you an object, and if you are dealing in a machine or in a computer system, if somebody asks you, if your boss asks you, if your higher authorities ask you, what is this, you should be able to explain it with clarity. Only for that purpose we learn expanding a compound noun. Say for example, okay, this table is made of wood and we call it as wooden table. So the first is wood, second one is table. Okay, if you want to expand this, we call it as a table made of wood. Okay, fine. So this gives more clarity. Fine. So two or more nouns put together, we call it as compound nouns. So the main purpose, I already told you, to describe the given object in a greater detail with clarity. Only for that purpose we expand compound nouns. Okay, now let's see how are we going to expand a compound noun. The formula is XY becomes YX. If it is a two word, the first word we call it as X, second word we call it as Y. So if you want to expand, okay, very simple, you need to make it as YX. XY, I mean 1, 2 becomes 2, 1, that's it. And if it is a three word, we name it as X, Y, Z, and it becomes EZ, Y, X. Okay. Say for example, 1, 2, 3 becomes 3, 2, 1. That's it. So let's quickly recall. XY becomes YX. I mean 1, 2 becomes 2, 1. XY, EZ becomes EZ, YX. Okay. I mean 1, 2, 3 becomes 3, 2, 1, and in between we will add, for some words we will add some prepositions, and for some we use phrasal verbs, and for some we use verb plus preposition, and for some we use, you know, verb plus ing. Let's see one by one. So first let us learn how are we going to bring that here, you know, XY becomes YX. Okay, say for example, power source. Power is X, source is Y. This is 1 and this is 2, and this is a compound noun, because two nouns put together we call it as compound noun. So it becomes source of power. Source of power. Power source becomes source of power. XY becomes YX, or 1, 2 becomes 2, 1, and in between we are adding one preposition, and this is an example. Okay, fine. Water supply. Supply of water. Engineering college. College of engineering. So it gives more meaning when you expand a compound noun in English. Okay, now let's see what are the other ways in which we can expand a compound noun. Say for example, arithmetic unit. So arithmetic is x, unit is y. So when you expand it, it will be opposite. XY becomes YX, a unit in which arithmetic is performed. A unit in which arithmetic is performed. Look at the second one, nickel alloy. Already I told you, you can even make it as ing form, I mean gerund form, verb plus ing. Alloy containing nickel, XY. Nickel alloy is expanded as alloy containing nickel. And look at the third one, verb plus preposition, I told you. XY, concrete structure becomes structure made of concrete. And the fourth one, we are using a conjunction. Locked at XY becomes YX, a nut that locks. Okay? And the last one is butterfly valve. XY, a valve in the shape of butterfly. So in the examination, they will give you compound nouns. Don't be confused. Very simple. Apply this formula, you will get the answer. That is XY becomes YX, XYZ becomes ZYX, or you can remember like this, 1, 2 becomes 2, 1, or 1, 2, 3 becomes 3, 2, 1. So the first change what we have made in a compound noun is, we are expanding by using a preposition. That is, power source becomes source of power. One example we have already seen. And next is, a unit in which arithmetic is performed. And third one is alloy containing nickel, I mean gerund form. Fourth one is verb plus preposition. Concrete structure becomes structure made of concrete. And the next one is a nut that locks. Lock nut becomes a nut that locks. And butterfly valve, we can even say a valve in the shape of butterfly. So there are four ways. One is expanding by using a preposition, then verb plus ing form, then by expanding it with a conjunction that, or you can, fourth one is you can even talk about the shapes, and the last one is ing form. So this is how you need to expand a compound noun. Now we have seen only two compound nouns. Let's see how are we going to expand the three compound nouns with three. Already I told you, XYZ becomes EZYX. So look at this, power, transmission, problem, XYZ. Problem in the transmission of power. Problem in the transmission of power. So this is how you need to expand. 1, 2, 3 becomes 3, 2, 1. And look at the next one, generator power output, X, Y, Z. Output of power from generator. Output of power from generator. So you need to just think of, ponder, okay, which preposition will be the right preposition to expand the compound noun, on which verb or which word or which conjunction, so that very easily you can expand any compound noun. And look at the next one, it is machine testing conditions, X, Y, Z. This is slightly, it's an exemption. You see, conditions under which machines are tested. In certain cases it will come like this, but mostly I would say X, Y, Z will become Z, Y, X. There are some exceptions like this. Machine testing conditions, conditions under which machines are tested. So this is how you need to expand a compound noun. Now let's have a quick recall. Compound noun means two or more nouns put together, we call it as compound noun. The best way to expand a compound noun is xy becomes yx, xyz becomes zyx, or you can remember through numbers 1, 2 becomes 2, 1, 1, 2, 3 becomes 3, 2, 1. The main purpose is to explain the given object in a greater detail, okay? And while you are expanding, you can expanding in four different ways. Insert one preposition, verb plus preposition, verb plus ing form or conjunction. That's it. Thank you.